Hello and welcome back to Evolve Models with me, Chris. Today we're going to start the build process for the Skoda PA2 Turtle. Hopefully you've seen the review I've done on this kit already. It looks like a cracking little kit. It's a painter sort of kit rather than the builders, so I'm hopefully going to throw this together relatively quickly and nicely and then we can get onto some painting. But this first part of the video is going to be mainly getting it all built up, get the plastic put together, and hopefully if we can get a base coat of primer on there, and then we can move on to a video on actual painting it, because admittedly painting this is going to be a lot of fun. It could be a lot of a headache as well, but I'm looking forward to it. So first part, I'm going to get started with this kit and get the plastic together. Thank you. So after a few hours work, we've got the basic kit together. Essentially, there's only a couple bits missing off here at the moment. Let me show you. There is a ring or hoop that goes around the ceiling, the roof of the unit there. But this, as you can see, is pretty crap, and I think I could do better with a bit of metal, some brass, maybe, and get about one of those going. So I've left that off the time being. That's rubbish. There are some little pins that essentially hold that rail system onto the top of the vehicle. I don't obviously need those at this point, but for where we're at now, we are ready for primer. That's going to be in another video. I've been working on this now for a fair few hours, and I've had enough of it really for the time being. We'll come back to this in the next video. We'll get it primed up and we'll get some of this paintwork on there. It's going to be quite interesting seeing how this comes out. It's it's going to be a difficult camo scheme, but we're going to give it a go and see what happens. You may notice I didn't do the cutout on the air vents. I did look at doing that with a Dremel of some kind, but I thought it was just going to make a mess of the plastic and there was no need for it really. The guns are in, more machine guns, they're just loose, they just pop in and out for the time being. All the lenses are missing, again for the time being, until we paint it up. But it was a relatively quick and enjoyable kit to build. There's a few weird things, putting the plastic together, the inner wheel art sections, which was just odd. But apart from that, yeah, generally good. So I will see you next time when we can actually get some paint on this and get moving with the camo.